depress you? Does it depress you that this is the character that people are clamoring for?
Oh, it's deeply depressing.
Does it depress you that this is the guy who's considered a man? This is a man in the AEW verse.
I see this at this point, and I'm making a lot of jokes. I made his, Midwest emo song there, and I put that up on the YouTube, and I got a good laugh out of it. But I think I said this a couple of weeks ago on the show, and now even more so than ever. I'm starting to feel slightly concerned for the guy.
Yeah.
To be honest with you. I mean, it really seems like we have either artistically made a choice to where we're just going to try to be like an American Psycho character or something. I don't know. But it really feels like the talk of hurting ourselves or hurting others and death and dying and suicide, like this is becoming a pretty fucking common in this guy's promos. I'm just saying, like, not even trying to be fucking overly dramatic or anything, but if Drew McIntyre kept coming out and he was like, "And then what happened was she broke up with me and I almost decided to fall on my own sword," we'd be like, all right, well, I guess he did that. What a fucking choice, I guess. But if he did it multiple times and kept talking about how sad he was and how no one has ever loved him, I'd be like, can somebody go check on Drew? But that's a part of his character. Since when? Since fucking when? Hasn't this guy been the pompous, I'm the rich kid? And I guess maybe you could say, well, I guess it's, they're trying to branch him out or whatever. But
yeah, but that's not a rich kid action. When you're talking about people doing the whole gothy bit, goths are the outcasts. MJF was a guy front and center. It's not in his character. I don't see it as flattering. Look, I like the idea of them touching upon things like death, but you have to do it in a very specific way in wrestling. Talking about killing your ex-girlfriend or almost killing her and dragging her out to the fucking pavement or whatever so that the cops think that she was driving, that's not endearing even as a heel, right? If you're going to talk about death in wrestling, I think the best way to do it is not even the way that the Kane and Undertaker storyline took place. Like, I always thought that was kind of corny too. My parents died in a fire, but my brother lived. Like that, when I want people to talk about death, I want them to talk about how dangerous a match is. I want them to talk about the Elimination Chamber, like this steel could actually cave in somebody's fucking head.
Mish, that's because it's relevant to what you're trying to sell.
Well, isn't that what you're trying to do is sell things?
Yes, exactly. That's what I'm saying. Like, it makes fucking sense. It would be very confusing if somebody was playing for the NBA championship, right? And they were having an interview and they were like, "Oh, how are your knees doing?" And it's like, "I really miss my dead uncle." It's like, what?
Right.
What are you saying? It's just like,
his knees his nickname? Like,
are you dedicating this game to him? Nope. Just miss him. Yeah. I might kill myself too. Fuck it. Like, what? What is going on?
No. I've already seen the conspiracy mill going too. Do you think this is all an act because it's been rumored that MJF was in contact with WWE for a contract?
I don't know, but he's got to tread lightly because at this point, if WWE is seeing these weird promos, and I get it. It's supposed to be like, oh, listen, it's a work or whatever. But they don't want you to be all over national television cutting promos about how you want to fucking die all the time.
Right.
It's one thing if Darby Allin's sitting there and he's like, lower me into my fucking grave. And he's dressed like a ghoul. But the rich kid who comes out with the scarf that has like suicide idolations, it's fucking weird.
But let's be honest, it fits his character. Darby Allin being all moody and broody and shit and wearing the fucking punk makeup and the punk goth lifestyle and being depressed and being a suicidal wrestling personality. Like, it almost makes sense. That's why he does the crazy dives. That's why he puts his body on the line. In that scenario, if he was to sit there and say, I don't care about death, I just want to wrestle, you'd almost be like, okay, I mean, that's who you are, kid. Go literally try and kill yourself.
Yeah, and what we see you do in the wrestling ring, it makes sense.
Right, right. MJF isn't that guy, though. Can you see MJF just jumping off of fucking scaffolds and shit? Like, I don't know, man.
MJF is cutting promos like he's Aleister Black.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Like, if Aleister Black was standing in the room with the dark candle and he's like, you know, I once knew what love was, and I thought that the world was, you know, she changed the way I look at the world, and now she left me. I am unlovable. I am I am untouchable. Blah, blah, blah. I'd be like, oh, all right.
He's going to text me and fucking act like a pussy. What do you want me to fucking do?
I'm before this fucking video.
Wait. I don't know. There's a odd little.
Some of that noseweed.
It's me. I want you to fucking text Schlock.
Is anything on this? Get rid of that on the table, please. I don't want it on.
Wait, what's on the table? Now I want to know what's on the table. What's on the table? Why do we gotta get rid of what's on the table?
Weed. Table weed.
Table weed. Oh, yes. Jesus.
Teddy. Yeah,
that.
So put it away before I accidentally film it.
It's been put away. My hands are still faster than anybody else's out there, so we'll see what happens with.
I bet they are, Ted. I bet they are. Fastest hands in the north, they call you. You see how fast I got rid of that table weed, eh?
Wrestling Soup will be right back.